I called Chief O'Brien. Now let her go.
Maybe I'll wait until he gets here.
If you don't let her go, I'll tell the chief the noise went away by itself.
You think I want to be doing this? I'm just making sure things get done. Unbelievable. This is the thanks I get.
Are you all right? Come in.
Miles.
I wonder if you can find out what's making that noise. I know you can't hear it, but it's there. Probably a sympathetic vibration, a power coupling or something.
What do you know? You're right.
Well, why don't you fix it, dear fellow? Well, why don't you fix it before I go mad?
He's married.
Too bad.
Sounds like the plasma flows out of sync.
You're right.
Better realign it.
I was just thinking that.
Yeah.
It's about to start.
Almost finished. There. Finally.
Oh. Much better, thank you, Chief.
Fellow citizens, these are great days for Cardassia. Together, with our Dominion allies, we have given our enemies cause to fear us once more.
Can't argue with that.
Who's he?
It's Damar, the new head of the Cardassian government.
Uneasy lies the head that wears the crown.
He's sad.
Ashamed is more like it.
From this position of strength, we are poised to make another bold step to ensure our future. Peace.
Looks like a man who doesn't sleep.
He thought I heard a voice cry, "Sleep no more." Damar does murder sleep.
He's killed someone.
Someone close to him.
How could they know that?
Their blood to defend their home. Their sacrifice must not be in vain. The peace we seek will honor their memory and preserve the gains for which they gave their lives. I challenge the Federation to answer my call for peace. I am ready at any time to meet with its representatives to discuss how we can put an end to hostilities. As your leader,
Pretender?
I pledge
you don't belong on that throne and you know it.
In my power to protect Cardassia.
Someone's making him say all this. He doesn't want to.
Into a new era. This I vow with my life's blood. For my sons. For all our sons.
Did any of you know who Damar was before today?
No. But it's obvious who he is. The Pretender. Who killed the king and seized the throne.
Not the king. He's still alive.
Well, the queen, maybe. Oh, or a princess.
Mm. Yes, Ziel, the Skaldekar's daughter.
And now the Pretender finds himself in league with a Dark Knight that he can't control.
Mm-hmm. Wayum.
It's not a bad story. Epic, really. What else can you tell us?
Mm-hmm. It was amazing. They pieced together the entire story of how Damar came to power. Wayun is the Dark Prince, Skaldekar is the deposed king, Damar is the Pretender to the throne, and Ziyal is the innocent princess he murdered. And now the Pretender is racked with guilt over what he's done.
And they got all this just from watching Damar's speech?
Oh, they were fascinated by the whole thing. They kept bombarding me with questions about Cardassia and the war. I've never seen them so engaged.
And you want to keep them engaged?
I'd like to try. I'm just running out of material.
What do you mean?
Well, they've already gone through everything the computer has on Cardassia and the Dominion.
Roll out the red carpet.
Visitors?
Starfleet has decided to listen to what Damar has to say. He and Wayun will be arriving in the morning. And I am the lucky one who gets a chance to sit across the table from them.
That's great. It's hard to believe that the Dominion really wants peace. I wouldn't be surprised if they were just stalling for time in order to regroup.
So, is there any chance I can get a transcript of the negotiations?
You can do better than that. The Dominion has insisted on recording the proceedings so that everyone can see that their desire for peace is sincere.
Perfect.
You shouldn't have agreed to that, Benjamin. Now you'll have to be on your best behavior.
So the Pretender and his Dark Knight are coming to the station, And the story's not over, huh?
Peace talks could be interesting.
I'd say so. And the best part is, we're gonna have ringside seats.
Ah, Major.